for months and months and months, I've been telling this person that I'm with, my partner, girl, I've been telling her that I know she's keeping something from me again. She's cheated on me many times in the past. All right, this is a 4-page front and back, well, 3-page front and back letter. It says, Mr. Came on.
That's me.
My vow. Okay. I'm not going to read the whole thing, or should I? Yeah, what the heck. Mr. Came on. You said before you fell asleep that I can't even admit that I'm effed up. And I'm cleaning it up for television. Well, it may be hard to say, but I can write it. I am effed up. I kept the secret of Ben's visits from you because I didn't think you'd believe I turned him down. You may not believe that even now, but his proposition wasn't to get in my pants. Whatever. What's the point of a relationship if you don't get on somebody's pants? Anyway. But he talked about a relationship, someone to grow old with, because he was tired of being alone. Aww, poor guy, even though he knows you're with somebody, and he's hitting on you, and he gives you a card, and comes in there day after day trying to sweet talk you just to get in your pants. Okay. Being alone. I chose you. Wow. Oh, I'm touched. This is somebody that she messed around with. She said we were still together, but she goes off and buys presents for this guy. And at the point, I end up getting, I got stuck in there. So I end up going to a jumpsuit, which sucks. Any of you people that's been in that, you know what I'm talking about. That sucks. I was in a jumpsuit for 2 months. Not only that, but she's buying presents for him while I'm in there with no money on my books. No, not a penny to my name. Eating that crap day after day for 2 months straight until I got out. While she's buying presents for him. So, even though I chose him while you were locked up, the second time around, I chose you. Wow, again, I'm so touched. By letting him know I would not leave you for him, keeping the card was stupid. That's right, she kept the card for months when I said she's keeping something from me, and she kept claiming she wasn't. And then threw the card at me during a heated argument. And I have no valid or reasonable explanation for it. Of course you don't. Except that you were considering, maybe I could go with somebody else. Maybe him, you know. Like you've done in the past, but you keep running back to me. Truthfully, I'm glad it's gone. Because I ripped it up and spit on it and threw it at her and said, why don't you take your whole entire income tax check and get out? Leave me and Starla. Well, I guess I've used her name a million times before. Leave me and Starla alone. Go. Be gone. Poof. I know you're angry and you have every right to be, but I just want to live a peaceful life and I want you to be in it. I just want to start completely over. I know in my heart, and I am not all bad and here like you think I am. I was stuck in a nut rut for a long time, repeating bad behaviors, but I'm not lying when I tell you I haven't slept with anyone since the last time that you are aware of. I have flirted a few times, but I never went anywhere. I didn't want it to go I didn't want to anyway. I sit in my chair all the time because it is my comfort zone. I know that's effed up, but I feel safe and in control of myself here. Yes, I'm writing this in the chair. It's times I do feel as if I'm closing my mind to something unseen. I can't believe I'm admitting that to you, you'll probably use it against me in the long run. You say your mind is always going. Mine is too, just not in the same way. Most of the time it's all just nonsense, but sometimes I zone out because I can't concentrate on anything, and then afterwards I immediately get tired. This is all very new to me and just recently started happening. Sometimes it makes me feel ill, and I want to reach out to you to help me make sense of it all, but I never have. That is why I pick at things. It helps me see things. Shouldn't there be a two in there? Clearer. Maybe I'm stressed out, I am mental. I just don't know. As far as sex goes, I really even, I hardly ever think about it. Sometimes I get a small urge, but then it usually goes away. But today, it didn't, and that's why I wanted Starla to go to bed. Believe it or not, I was charming you. But when you shot me down, it was like a million little needles had dug their way under my skin. I couldn't understand why you were so adamant about me initiating things, but I got shot down when I was trying. That all too familiar voice said to me that something was going on. How can someone so interested in sex say no if he's not getting it somewhere? I've let that voice do a lot of harm over the years. The difference between you and I is that you've always loved sex, and the only sex that was good for me has been with you. The few guys before you, you were terrible. I can believe that. Because I know what the heck I'm doing. I try to, get into things. And, if you're going to do it, you might as well enjoy it. You might as well like the person you're with. Not just, roll over and go to sleep or something, I literally thought it was something you just do. Because, in my mind, it was natural. Even when I effed around, it was terrible, and it was never with. I was never with it. Basically, she's saying that everybody else, it was crap, and she just thought it was something you had to do, and she never enjoyed it until me. Which is the reason why I'm guessing she keeps going to mess around, especially if she gets mad at me, which she's got mad at me before in a little argument and then went off and had sex with someone. Now, how can you do that? We argue about, a toaster oven, and you go have sex with someone? That's valid. Yeah, and I'm still here. And this is going on for about 7 years now. Should I be gone by now? The only thing I got was a millisecond of victory, and that's why I vowed I'd never do it again. Yes, I've played games and did bitchy things to piss you off, but I have not been with anyone else. I really want another chance. If I screw up and do something else really bad, I promise I'll walk away and leave Starla with you. For my birthday, any holiday, I would just be home with you. Please don't end this. I'll tell you everything from now on. I know you've heard all this before, but it's never been this dangerously close to the end. I truly don't want to lose you, and I'll do whatever it takes, including letting you be with other people. Just name what you want. And I've heard that one before too. But so this is my question to everybody. Do you what do you think about it?